So TISNET is basically for HR, MDI, and SCM-HRD also have HR courses. Accelera is the top B school for HR. Then you have IRMA, XIM, and IIFM. These are into rural and developmental sectors. IIMs also offer agri-business management. VAMNICOM, you know, people don't even speak about VAMNICOM when they speak of B schools. This is Vaikunth Mehta Institute for Cooperative Management. So it's in Pune. It's located in Pune. And not many people are even aware of this institute. It's a very good institute, provided you're looking at cooperative management. And then you have MICA, NITI, MICA into advertising and branding, NITI into operations, NIBM into banking. So if you're looking at sector-specific B schools, these are some of the sector-specific B schools which you can target. And as I said, I'm not spending a lot of time on this. These are some of the other B schools. These are Catalytes, IMI, TAPMI, BIM, KJSOM, Wellinker, Sydenham, Nirmal. So these are all B schools where that multiplier of 3 to 4 times will take place. You know, only those schools I have listed here. And we will come back to these cutoff percentiles after some time. Let us look at CAT as an exam. You know, why it's important to understand CAT as an exam. If you look at the number of CAT aspirants, 2011, the number of aspirants was 2 lakhs roughly. And if you look at 2020 figure, despite COVID, despite everything, you still have 2.2 lakh people taking CAT, aspiring for CAT. The largest number that I have seen is somewhere in the vicinity of 3 lakhs. That was in 2007-8. But then the number declined by around 50,000. And I feel it has remained steady around 2.5 lakhs in the last 3-4 years. I expect it to grow back to 3.0 lakhs with the increasing number of IIMs and with the decreasing Sarkari opportunities or government opportunities. So why this number is important for you to know? You know, if you have to secure admission into a top B school, you have to be in the top 10,000 people. So what percent of students will get into a top B school? And it's not just IIMs. When I say top B schools, it would be roughly the top 40, 50 B schools in India. So there would be around 10,000 admissions. And what percent is that? That comes to around 4%. So 4% of all applicants are going to get selected in top B schools. This percentage is important to know because this percentage varies for different exams. Now, how many of you have also appeared for Sarkari exams? For Sarkari exams, that percentage will be less than 0.1% for Sarkari exams. So that is the comparative ease with which you can secure admission to a good B school in India. Then about the CAT exam, it's a computer-based test conducted by TCS. Till 2020, for the last 3-4 years, there had been 100 questions with 3 sections. And mind you, there were 34 and 32 questions in quant, verbal, and DILR respectively. Because now we are getting into this serious stuff, talking about what is the CAT pattern with respect to different sections. So when we say quantitative aptitude, what is the meaning of quantitative aptitude and how is it different from mathematics? Yes, somebody has raised a hand. Yes, Kushal. Kushal, you have a question for me?
No, sir.
You've raised a hand.
Sir, you actually asked who have been appeared in Sarkari exams for okay. That.
So I'm just trying to give you a comparative between Sarkari and CAT. Anyways, so when we say quantitative aptitude, there are primarily 4 areas: arithmetic, algebra, geometry, and numbers and counting. These are 4 areas from which you will see questions. Arithmetic is everything that you've learned in maths till class 9th or 10th. Ek cheez dhyan rakhna, CAT syllabus mein kabhi bhi 10th class ke upar, CBSE ka jo 10th class ka syllabus hai, you will never have questions beyond this in CAT. Every concept that is tested is within this CBSE 10th. And the reason is they allow everyone to take CAT. But there is no qualifying criteria except that you have to have 50% in your graduation. But there is no other qualifying criteria to take CAT. As long as you can solve those questions of quantitative aptitude, DILR, and verbal ability, you are free to take CAT and you are free to join NIMs if you get admission there. We'll come to this in a moment. We'll come back to this slide. Now, look at this comparative for the last 4 years. CAT 2017, CAT 2018, CAT 2019, CAT 2020. 12 to 14 questions arithmetic, 13 to 14 questions arithmetic, 14 questions arithmetic. This is 10 questions of arithmetic, but out of 26. What does this tell you? Around 40% of questions in CAT definitely will appear from arithmetic. And I have seen this for the last 25 years. In fact, more than 25 years. 25 years back, this percentage used to be much higher. But in the last 15, 20 years, the percentage has come to around 40% of questions of CAT are arithmetic. Arithmetic means percentage, average, profit and loss, ratio, time work, time distance. This is what arithmetic is. Then around 6 to 8 questions of geometry in 2017, 6 to 7 questions in 2018, 6 to 8 questions again in 2019, and 3 out of 26 questions in CAT 2020. Here the number has declined, but I'm sure that's not a very permanent decline. It's temporary. But you see that roughly 16 to 20% of the questions are from geometry, always. Similarly, algebra, you can see, and what does algebra comprise? Okay, what does geometry comprise? Geometry means mensuration, geometry, coordinate geometry, and trigonometry. Very basic, very elementary trigonometry, which you learn in class 10. Then CAT 17, 18, 19, 20, look at the number of questions of algebra. You have 7 questions in 2017, 7 questions in 2018, 6 to 7 questions again in 2019, and 8 questions in 2020. So it tells you that in terms of number of questions, algebra has remained again rock solid at around 20 to 25%. And what does algebra mean? Algebra means equations, inequations, functions, sequence, and series, and set theory. So these are 6 topics which broadly are clubbed as algebra. And then you have numbers and counting, again, 7s, so 20%. So you can see that arithmetic is 40%. The remaining areas are roughly 20%, 20%, 20% in most of the years as far as CAT is concerned. Now, why it is important to know that? Now, suppose I'm starting now and I'm weak on maths. So I need to be able to prioritize kaun se topics karna hai aur kaun se nahi karna hai. So mujhe maloom hai, I can't leave out arithmetic. There's no way I can leave out arithmetic. If I want to leave out, probably I'll leave out algebra. Because I am weak on arithmetic and I am fundamentally not very good at algebra. So, you know, I want to be able to take such decisions in order to prioritize my preparation. Meri preparation ko prioritize karne ke liye, decision lene ke liye ye breakup pata hona chahiye. Any questions on this breakup? Because there is another aspect to the quantitative aptitude. Because what is the difference between quantitative aptitude and mathematics? You might ask, you know, people ask me, sir, ye quantitative aptitude maths hi to hota hai? Nahin, maths nahin hota hai. Quantitative aptitude aur maths mein bahut antar hai. Mathematics mein, they are going to ask you formula-based questions also. Under mathematics, they are going to ask you questions which are directly related to what you see in the books. Probably some questions are repeated. Jaise aapke 10th, 11th, 12th or graduation exams mein hota hai. But aptitude mein questions rarely repeat. You know, questions never repeat. There will always be questions in a particular context. For example, a permutation combination question can be related to your cell phones. फॉर एग्जाम्पल सेलफोन्स में आपने ऐसा कुछ देखा होता है क्या? ऐसा कुछ देखते हो सेलफोन्स में जो मैंने बनाया डॉट 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 डॉट, क्या ये?
सर अनलॉक अनलॉक स्क्रीन
या
पैटर्न।
अनलॉक स्क्रीन करने के लिए। सो आई कैन आस्क यू अ क्वेश्चन दैट यू नो आई क्रिएट अ पैटर्न बाय ड्राइंग थ्री लाइंस एंड आई गिव यू वन सैंपल पैटर्न, ठीक है? सो हाउ मेनी डिफरेंट पैटर्न्स कैन आई ड्रॉ यूजिंग थ्री लाइन? यू नो दिस इज एन एप्लीकेशन क्वेश्चन, दिस इज नॉट डायरेक्ट क्वेश्चन, इट इज एन एप्लीकेशन क्वेश्चन ऑन कॉम्बिनेशन एंड परम्यूटेशन। सो अनलेस योर फंडाज आर क्लियर, अनलेस यू नो दैट द कॉन्सेप्ट टू बी अप्लाइड इज दैट ऑफ नंबर्स एंड काउंटिंग, यू आर नॉट गोइंग टू बी एबल टू सॉल्व द क्वेश्चन। सो द क्वेश्चंस आर नॉट स्ट्रेट फॉरवर्ड, द क्वेश्चंस विल बी इन अ पर्टिकुलर कॉन्टेक्स्ट एंड यू नो देर माइट बी अ प्रोबेबिलिटी क्वेश्चन इन सम कॉन्टेक्स्ट, देर माइट बी अ नंबर थ्योरी क्वेश्चन इन सम कॉन्टेक्स्ट, देर माइट बी एन अरिथमेटिक क्वेश्चन इन अ कॉन्टेक्स्ट, एंड दैट डिफरेंशिएट्स द काइंड ऑफ क्वेश्चन दैट अपियर इन कैट और एनी एमबीए एंट्रेंस एग्जाम एंड दैट डिफरेंशिएट्स देम फ्रॉम नॉर्मल अरिथमेटिक और मैथमेटिक्स क्वेश्चन। The second thing is they are hardly direct. You know, in the last so many years that I have seen CAT, I have not seen a single question which is based on a direct formula. You know, later on you can create a shortcut for every question. You know, even I can create shortcuts for every question. But in that, in those 2-2.5 hours, unless your fundas are correct, unless your fundas are clear, unless you know which concept to apply, you'll not be able to solve the question. As simple as that. So there are hardly any direct questions. So if you are somebody who likes to learn mathematics by mugging up formulae, you should just stop doing that. Because mugging up is never going to help you clear CAT. In fact, you know, I have had some interactions with professors and, you know, I asked them, what is that one quality that you're looking at in a CAT aspirant? And they say reasoning. And when you probe them further, they say for mathematical analysis, we have softwares. But there is no software for reasoning yet. And that is why if they, you know, every question will also be automatically an application or a reasoning question. That's the fundamental difference between quantitative aptitude and mathematics. How do you prepare for this? You prepare for this topic by making some basic changes, fundamental changes in your approach. Fundamental changes in your approach to calculations. Fundamental changes in the way you will solve questions. For example, arithmetic questions. You know, I don't have any sample question right now with me, but many of you solve arithmetic questions by writing down equations. So you need to change that and see how you can solve questions visually, how you can solve questions orally. This change has to be brought about. If you want to crack CAT, if you want to crack any MBA entrance exams, if you want to solve questions in limited time, now this change has to be brought. Focus on basics. In fact, out of 100% of the time, you should spend around 30 to 40% of the time on basics only. And the remaining 60% on solving moderate difficulty level questions. I see and I get many students every year who love to solve tough, tricky questions of CAT. I buy questions solve karte hain. Ulte seedhe questions solve karte hain. Kabhi bhi ulte seedhe questions solve karne se CAT mein selection nahi hota. You know, there are Facebook groups. You know, even I solve some doubts on those groups. And people ask me questions jo JE mein bhi nahi aane wale. They might appear in Olympiads, not in JE. And they feel that such questions, by solving such questions, they are preparing for CAT. No. Because in CAT, the mathematical part will be hardly anything. In percentage, all you need to know is how to calculate basic percentage. That's all mathematics you require to know. What is more important is where you have to apply that. And that is why solving utpatang tough questions is never going to help you in cracking the quantitative aptitude question on कैट. ऐसा होता तो आई वुड हैव नेवर सिक्योर्ड 99th परसेंटाइल इन क्वांट. नो आई एम एवरेज इन क्वांट. आई टीच क्वांट बट आई एम एवरेज इन क्वांट. आई एम एवरेज इन मैथ्स. आई सिक्योर्ड 99th परसेंटाइल ओनली बिकॉज आई वॉज एबल टू रिलेट अ कॉन्सेप्ट टू दैट एप्लीकेशन. दैट्स ऑल. दैट्स द बिगेस्ट स्किल दैट यू नीड. सो यू नीड टू चेंज योर अप्रोच. And when you are solving questions, spend most of your time on solving moderate level questions. Most of your time. So, if you have 60% of your time devoted to practice, probably 10% on easy, 20% on tough, 30% on moderate. This is how I would break up roughly. Everybody will vary a bit here and there. But if I were to, you know, if I were to prepare for CAT and spend most of my time, I would spend on moderate questions. If I have limited time, I would spend most of my time here, not on tough questions. Because tough questions will not decide the percentile cutoffs. Are we clear? You know, I hope I have made this amply clear. Then, what about verbal ability? Now, what are they testing on verbal ability again? Before we look at what are they testing, let us see what has happened in verbal ability in the last 4 years. One constant that I can see is reading comprehension, 24, 24, 24, 18. This is out of 34. This is out of 34. This is out of 34. This is out of 26. What does it tell you? What is the most important thing in English? You know, it is no-brainer now. The most important thing in English is reading comprehension, without a doubt. And if anybody asks me, in areas where people are generally weak on English, English is a bigger factor for failure or for not being able to crack CAT than quant, any of the quant sections. Because many people feel they're good at English. Many people feel, you know, they can speak English well, ergo, they are good at English. You know, speaking English is not equivalent to being good on the verbal ability section of CAT. Just understand this difference very clearly. Speaking English is one skill. Being good on the verbal ability section is absolutely different. But one thing is sure, that reading comprehension is the most important thing. Then you have para jumbles. 3-4, 3-4 out of, you have parasummaries again, 3-3, 3-3. So the pattern of CAT as far as verbal ability is concerned is probably the most standardized one in the last 4-5 years that I have been seeing CAT. Why? Because the questions are almost similar. The questions, the level of difficulty is almost similar. Now you may have one or two passages here and there which are very, very tough to read. But then what I have seen is more or less the level of difficulty in English is almost similar in the last 3-5 years of CAT. Now let us go back here. What are they testing? They are testing vocabulary indirectly. They are testing your ability to comprehend with speed. And it is not just comprehension, which is basically memory of facts. Comprehension means, again, you're understanding the passage and being able to apply that information to answer questions. So it's not straightforward comprehension. It's not something that you saw in your school. So, for example, in your school, you might have had a passage that Dasharatha had 4 sons, Ram, Lakshman, Bharat, Shatrughna, and, you know, they tell you all the story. And in school, the question would have been, who among the following is not Ram's brother? And you very happily answer 4 questions. In CAT, such questions will never appear. The kind of questions that can appear is, if the facts given in the passage are true, then which of the following would also be true? Now, this question requires thinking. This question requires a thorough understanding of the facts of the passage. So, it tests your ability to understand the structure of the passages, structure of the sentences. You know, these are the primary things that are being tested in verbal ability. And obviously, what is the quality of language? What, when I say you should be good at English or you should be good at vocabulary, does it mean that I have to, you know, mug up dictionaries? No. I have seen students do that also. You know, many students try to mug up dictionaries. You know, it's really silly to think of, you know, even to try to mug up dictionaries. What you require is read newspapers, read daily newspapers, the Hindu, Indian Express, Guardian. Get hold of good newspapers, see whether you are able to understand the language of those newspapers. If you are primarily able to understand the language of those newspapers, you are good to go. If you're not able to understand the language of these newspapers, then you need to work on vocab. So first is work on vocabulary. Second, work on grammar. Then you can work on comprehension and structure. People, you know, people start with grammar. Grammar is not the key to English. Vocabulary is the key to English. Vocabulary will be the key to any language. You know, how did you learn your mother tongue? Not through grammar. You know, probably till your sixth or seventh, you never had any grammar. But you are fluent in your mother tongue, right? So the key to any language is vocabulary first, then grammar, then comprehension and structure. How to prepare for vocabulary? And okay, what makes English challenging? Variety of topics. Now, topophilia, I'm sure none of you have even heard of this topic. This was one of the passages in the last 2 years. Folk music, Aladdin, shopping behavior. So the topics are so varied that unless you have a good level of reading, unless your reading is varied, you're unlikely to have appeared for or seen any of the topics. Options are close. And the sheer amount of reading that is required to be done in order to answer the question. That makes English challenging. How to prepare? Well, develop good reading habits. Again, I'm sure many of you are already aware of these things. Develop good reading habits. Read novels, read dailies. Many students have this doubt, sir, novel padhna chahiye ki nahi padhna chahiye? Bhai padho. Whatever helps you generate interest in reading, read that first. First interest, develop that interest. So reading is like old wine, right? It will taste better as the habit gets older. So start reading novels, start reading even comic books. No problems with that. Start somewhere if you've not already started. Work on vocab, make a habit of reading at least 1 odd hour, 1.5 hours every day. Work on grammar. Grammar is important. And three things, in fact, which I don't find many people doing. One, when they read, they don't have time limits. In fact, when you are preparing for any competitive exam, everything has to be done under time limits. You know, no leisurely solving of material, ever. Even if you're solving something for the first time, you should note down the time that you took to solve a particular question. That will give you a reference for the next time. And that applies to English, this applies to maths. In English, if you're leisurely reading a novel, don't read anything leisurely. Time yourself. So if you read something in, let's say you read 10 pages in 25 minutes, next time try to read them in 20 minutes. So that's how you will improve over a period of time, because improvement will not take place in one day. If your vocabulary is not in order, develop vocabulary. It will take you 2 to 3 months to come to terms with vocabulary. Work on grammar, and then you will see that improvement taking place if you have been reading all this while. The second thing that people don't do in English is they don't analyze their mistakes. Kitne logon ne RC diya hai isse pehle? How many of you have taken any RC test before? RC is reading comprehension. Kitne logon ne comprehension ke test liye hain isse pehle? Yeah. So do you go back and analyze the question which you got wrong? Did you go back and analyze the question which you got wrong? Most of you don't do. Sab alas kar jate hain isme. You have to actually go back and see why your answer was wrong. If you don't make a habit of doing such analysis, you will never improve on your mistakes. And I'm telling you this based on my experience. I have learned by analyzing mistakes and by working on them systematically. And it takes some time before you can improve. And then working on mistakes, there are many ways in which you can work on your mistakes, work on your weaker areas. One of them is logging, properly logging your mistakes. And we will talk about that more in due course. Then we have DILR questions. Now, this is the most dreaded section of CAT, at least in the last 4 to 5 years. सबसे ज्यादा लोग इसके नाम से रोते हैं. अगर किसी ने लास्ट ईयर कैट दिया होगा तो वो आज भी रोएगा इसके नाम से. बट कम टू थिंक, यू नो, जस्ट थिंक अबाउट इट. आउट ऑफ 32 क्वेश्चंस, इफ यू आर सॉल्विंग समवेयर अराउंड 8 to 9 क्वेश्चंस, यू आर वेरी क्लोज टू 90th परसेंटाइल इन कैट. दिस इज जस्ट टू केसलेट्स इन 1 hour. टू केसलेट्स, 3 केसलेट्स इन 1 hour. Not a very difficult task. If you plan for it and practice for it, this is not difficult. And what are the questions based on? Ratings and rankings, Venn diagrams, application of arithmetic primarily, and complex arrangement. So how do you prepare for this DILR section? And this is again a breakup of DILR section. I don't want to spend time on this because I want to tell you what we are going to do in the next 6 days. But you should have an idea of, you know, roughly eight sets are there if there are 32 questions of 4 questions each. Next is what to expect out of CAT 2021. Very, very difficult to answer. 100 questions or 76 questions? Well, this question will get answered probably in a month from now. I believe that if situation normalizes, they should go back to their 100 question pattern. If it doesn't, and if they feel that they have to increase the number of slots, then probably they will decrease the time and also the number of questions to be solved. Primarily, they reduced the number of questions only because they had to reduce the timing for the test last year. Correct? Adaptive or non-adaptive? Well, there was a talk about adaptive versus non-adaptive a few years back, but since COVID, I have heard nothing on this issue so far. You know, for the last 1.5 years, I have not heard a single word about CAT being adaptive or non-adaptive. Level of difficulty, last year, it did not change much. I don't expect the level of difficulty to be very, very different from what it has been, you know. And maths should be easy to moderate. Last year, many people found maths to be tough. You know, I came across quite a few students who found maths to be tough. So having said all that, what will we do in the next 6 days? You know, I would like to tell all of you, you know, about what we are going to discuss in the next 6 days. We are going to discuss a relatively tough topic from maths. That is number theory. We'll cover in adequate detail. We'll start from basics, right from divisibility criteria. After a divisibility criteria, we will go step by step, factors, divisors, remainder theorem, highest power of a prime factor. So there are a lot of subtopics. We will be solving class sheets that we solve in phase one at Pathfinder, plus a few old CAT questions related to this very topic. So I will share both of them. The class sheets for all those who have registered on the website, I have provided you with an access. If you log on to the website, you will be able to access the dashboard. And on the dashboard, you will be able to access materials that we will be using for the classes from tomorrow. Video lectures related to each and every concept are already there. So if you feel you are weak, you can just view the video lectures you can view them in the order in which they will be presented on the dashboard. So they are presented in a particular logical order and you can view them, come to the class. After viewing them, it will help. It will surely help. You have an access to booklet. This is a number theory booklet. You can go through the theory from the booklet also. In the class, my focus will be on solving class sheets after going through the theory quickly as you will permit me, all of you will permit me. This is the broad timetable which we will follow in the coming 6 to 7 days. The class will be of 1 hour every day. It will start at 8 p.m. And please, when I say 8 p.m., it starts latest by 8:03 p.m. Today also we started at 8:03. So it will start on time. And till 9 p.m. we will have this class till Sunday. There's one day and off in between. Thursday will be an off. Thursday you won't have the evening class. So tomorrow we will learn about classification. We will learn about divisibility criteria. And we will solve questions related to divisors. They are not easy. And, you know, probably many of you will find these things to be new. Fine. We will start with basics. And then we will step by step increase the level of difficulty. So this is your schedule for the next 6 days, 7 days, from basics to base system. And every day we will solve some questions of CAT that have appeared on concepts that are being taught in that particular day. So broadly, this is what we will do. Do you have any questions about CAT, about the schedule? Feel free to ask me. You know, it's always good to ask questions.
Sir.
Yeah.
Hello, sir. I have told you that I'm from BA. So okay. Will you suggest me joining MBA? Will it be good for me?
Okay.
That I want to ask.
Very good question. MBA managers are there for every segment, right? So even a soap company requires managers. Even a technology company, Infosys, will require managers. So managers are required in every sector. That is why IIMs also have added diversity as one of the factors. So if you come from a background that is different from engineering, or see, there used to be a time when around 80 to 90% of admissions to IIMs used to be engineers. Today that percent has dipped, primarily because IIMs have given importance to diversity. So if you come from a background which is non-engineering, you are basically at an advantage. You might get calls at lower percentiles, as low as 90th percentile. Does that answer your question?
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Any other question? Abhishek, where are you from? Abhishek Kale.
Yes, sir.
Where are you from?
Sir, Usmanabad.
Okay.
Maharashtra.
I know Usmanabad. So any questions, anybody? About the course, about CAT, please feel free to ask. Because from tomorrow, we will have to spend time on the subject. So today we have around 10 minutes. I can answer questions related to CAT, related to preparation, related to, like, you know, he just asked. Anyone? Nobody has questions? Yeah. Dinesh, you have another one? Chalo, if nobody has question, let us move one step forward. Shlok, MBA kis mein karna hai aapko? Finance mein karna hai, operations mein karna hai, marketing mein karna hai, kis mein karna hai?
Yes, sir. I have that question. Which branch will be best in MBA?
So which branch is best depends on the individual, depends on your own personality traits, your own liking.
Yes, sir.
So people are successful managers have done marketing, have also done operations, have also done finance. So you are successful from anywhere. Depends on the company where you join. Depends on the profile which you pick. So, you know, rather than asking which is the best, you see where you would have the most interest.
Yes,
now, start reading about job profiles, start reading about what kind of roles are there in the companies, and see whether you would like, for example, you know, many of you who like to travel, you know, they like marketing because marketing involves a lot of travel. But 10 years down the line, when you have a family of your own, travel becomes a, you know, issue. Then, you know, you have to start thinking all over again. So look at the negatives and positives of every branch that you can think of. There will be negatives. There will be positives. See whether the positives outweigh the negatives for you. If they do, then that is a good branch for you. Many, sure. Many girls, you know, many girls come and tell me, sir, humko to HR karna hai. You know, I have friends who are females and they are doing wonderfully well in marketing. You know, in fact, they are doing better than their husband in marketing. So, aisa kuch nahi likha hai ki, you know, if I am X, I should do marketing. If I am Y, I should do HR or finance. No, nothing of that sort. Another question that comes, you know, often is, sir, MBA without experience or MBA after 2 years of experience? What is your take on this? How many of you are working? Anyone who's working here? None of you are working?
They're doing. Hello, sir.
Yeah.
So I just want to ask, sir, I want to do MBA IB. Is it good?
MBA IB, International Business.
So MBA IT.
Yeah. If you want to see, if you want to get into IT, it is good to do operations or IT. Do MBA operations or IT. IT will become super specific. Operations will broaden. It will also allow you entry into IT. It will also allow you entry into operations. But IT, what? I mean, are you wanting to enter into operations of IT, marketing of IT? What kind of roles you want to assume?
Actually, it is MBA in Information Technology. So I want to do that.
Oh, you want to do MBA in Information Technology. So basically, you want to go into operations.
Yes, sir.
My suggestion would be go for MBA operations. And with operations background, you not only will have openings in IT, you will have openings in other areas as well. Supply chain, for instance.
Okay, sir. So I should go for MBA in operation, right?
Operations.
Okay, thank you very much, sir.
Sir, is
and, sir,
online
I am doing paid internship right now.
Sorry, you're doing?
Paid internship right now.
Okay, you're doing a paid internship. Great, fantastic. This will help you. Is it after graduation or before graduation?
So yes, it is after graduation.
This is going to help you.
Because I have completed graduation.
Yeah, anybody who completed graduation last year was definitely at a disadvantage when it came to
job. Not last year, but recently.
Okay, good. Yes, anybody else who has a question? Somebody was asking and stopped.
Sir?
Yes.
Sir, is online MBA worthy?
See, if you're looking at an MBA from the perspective of knowledge, online MBA is good. If you're looking at an MBA from the perspective of learning something, I would say that there are many skills which you learn when you're on campus. Trust me on this. So if you go to campus, you're interacting with your peers and you learn a lot from your fellow classmates. Not only do you learn from your professors, you also learn a lot from your classmates. You learn how to interact in a team. You learn how to solve problems in a team. You learn to carry out multiple activities. See, when you go to campus, let me give you an example. So on campus, you might be a part of one club, whatever. The club activity is simultaneous with your academic activity. So for example, you are associated with a movie club, right? Your role in the college is that every month or every week on a particular day, you have to organize a movie show. You are the organizer. So suppose that day is Friday and the next day there is an exam. Well, you will not be spared from the exam just because you are a part of this club. In fact, nobody is spared because of their other activities. You have to manage these activities together. And this is also an equally important learning, important part of a B school. And that helps you, you know, learn how to prioritize things, prioritize your activities. Abhi to kya hai ki work expands to fill whatever available time is there with you. But when you have limited time, you will know, you will learn how to prioritize that work. So online MBA depends on what is your objective of doing an MBA. If you are looking at jobs, if you are looking at skills, I don't think online MBA is good. If you are looking at bookish knowledge, online MBA is fantastic. You will learn. And that depends on how much you are willing to put in, how much effort you are willing to put in. Does that answer your question?
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Yeah, most welcome. Any other question? Any other question, please?
No, sir, nothing. Thank you.
Okay, so nobody has a question right now for? Okay, so in that case, I will close the session. Those of you who have not registered on the website, I'm just sharing the link. Please register on this website. So that I can provide you with access to the online material that is there. Just one sec.
Sir, if you say that we can get free admission in a MBA in other countries, foreign. So is it true we can get like that complete free 100% scholarship?
At least I have never heard of 100% scholarship in MBA, not from a worthy B school, not from a good B school. Scholarships, yes. Very good scholarship, yes. But, you know, all the good B schools that I know of, I don't think this is true. In fact, a foreign MBA...
In India also, sir?
See, MBA education will not come cheap. In fact, no education will come cheap anymore.
Yes, sir.
So, but, you know, if you're looking at a cost of spending around 15 to 20 lakhs on your MBA, what are you earning? Even if you get an average salary of 10 lakhs, 12 lakhs rupees, you spend 20 lakh rupees, that 12 lakh rupees is your first salary. What will that salary grow to in another 10, 15 years? Because this MBA, if you treat it like an expense, you know, it will, you know, you will feel the pinch. If you treat it like an investment, you're going to get returns every year. So MBA is an investment into your future.
Yes, sir.
Right?
Yes, sir. Thank you so much.
Sir, hello, sir.
Yes, please.
Sir, for BBA student, can any advantages for MBA?
Oh, there is a lot of, for, you know, the BBA degree, will it prove to be advantages? Is that what you're asking me?
Sir,
see,
BBA, colleges can provide any advantages?
No. No advantage for the degree per se. I don't think there will be anybody providing you advantage. But you will, you know, you're going to add to the diversity of the class. So to that extent, BBA, BCom will be very similar in terms of diversity.
Yes, sir.
Right? So that is the only advantage that you will have in the admission process. But whether the colleges will prefer you over somebody else, I don't think. You know, college would want to have good people. Diversity is not at the cost of good people. Diversity, along with the fact that you're good too. For example, you know, girls have special extra marks for diversity. But that doesn't mean that girls who are selected are not good. You know, they are selected only if they're good. So diversity matters provided they qualify that minimum criterion which they are supposed to qualify. Does that answer your question?
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, most welcome. Right, so I'll call it a day. Thank you very much for joining in.
Thank you so much, sir. Good night.
Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
We'll start with number theory tomorrow. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Most welcome. Thank you, Ganesh.